Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us is the budget deficit. Now, you know, every country, you know, have the problem of budget deficits. Sort of, at least India have one. Like, you know, over here, the Oman state's budget deficit for the first 7 months of 2018 plunged to 36.3% from a year earlier to 1.65 billion rials. Okay, we'll start with first and the foremost thing over here. We'll learn exactly what is the budget deficit. This is the first question. Okay, fine, we'll begin. See, the budget deficit is a deficit, you know, when revenues, they are less than the expenses for a particular year or a quarter. So when we talk about this, we usually talk about the government budget deficit, and it means that the government has spent more than the amount that has been collected. Okay, so other than this deficit, there are two concepts that are important in the case of the government budget. See, when the government collects more, let's say more money than it spends, we call it as budget surplus. Okay, now this happens. Now when it is equal, we call it budget as balanced, and this can also happen in the case of the individuals for the business. So when revenue exceeds, when the revenue is greater than the expenses, we call it as surplus. And if when we can see that the revenue and the expenses are equal, we call it as balance. Okay, the next thing we should learn on this is the formula part. See, budget deficit, BDF, that is the budget deficit formula, is equal to your total expenditures by the government less the total income of the government. So the total income of the government includes all the, like, you know, corporate taxes, personal taxes, stamp duties, okay, so on and so forth. And the total expenditure over here, total expenditure includes the expense in the defense, energy, and then we have science, healthcare, social security, and so on and so forth. Okay, now let me make you do some budget deficit calculation. Well, recently the US budget deficit, you know, it climbed around $779 billion and it's highest since 2012. So let us calculate the budget deficit of the United States. The total income breakup, you know, of the same is, like, you know, there is individual income tax, with that is standing at $1684 billion. Then there is social security and other payroll tax that is standing at $1171 billion. Then there is corporate taxes, which is standing at $205 billion, and other taxes, duties, that is standing at $270 billion. So the total income of US over here is $3 trillion, right? That is 330. So 3,330, that's closely $3 trillion. Now the expenditures, that is, you know, for the defense, which they did, $665 million, that is billion dollars. Social security, $998 billion. Medicare, that expenditure was $589 billion. Interest on debt, which they are paying, is $325 billion. And some other expenditures which they did was $1542. So this is the total expenditures. This is our total income. Now, when we deduct the budget deficit formula, if you just see that, you know, the income is less than your expenses, that is, you are short by $789 billion. So that is US budget deficit. So this is how you make the calculation part, right? Now I want to make you understand that what are the causes behind this deficits. So what are the factors that can cause the budget deficits? Let's have a look at one by one. Slow economic growth can be one thing. See, if a country's economy isn't going as fast as the government is spending money, the country can experience slow economic growth. A slow economic growth, that's fine. And due to the slow economic growth, due to the inflation or other economic factors, the government does not collect as much money as it has planned. So as a result, the government has to deal with the thing called deficit, right? Second thing is called the high government spending. See, if a government has been investing a lot of money into a particular project, then that would yield a huge gains in the future, then for the current period, it may create a what we call as deficit, right, for the government. So this is good if the government has spent the money on the sustainable growth of the investment or an infra. But it's futile, you know, if the expense does not ensure sustainable growth, for the expenses are incurred, you know, just to support some unsustainable overhead. Third reason can be, you know, high unemployment rate. So if a country is experiences a high unemployment rate, then maybe the government needs to pay more subsidies towards the particular purpose, and all the efforts should be given to improving the unemployment rate so that, you know, the amount of the subsidies can be reduced at the time of the economic growth that has been accelerated. And then there are some of the reason for the same as, you know, combination of all the above factors. So like the excessive government spending may not happen due to one particular reason, and it may happen that, you know, the particular combination of all the factors become responsible for the deficit in the country. So the government should make, you know, they have to keep the expenses low and create more revenues together, more revenues. Now the next thing is, government budget deficit, is it bad? Well, to answer this, but no, over here you need to think that in the government deficit is always bad. No, actually the answer is no. Actually, to the investors and the financial analysts, there are two important factors to determine whether or not the government deficit is good for the country or not. The first factor is why government expenditure is so high. See, is it because the government has invested a particular infra or invested money in an investment that will yield high returns? If that's the case, then the financial analyst gives, you know, a green signal to the government. If not, the analyst mark them as a poor expenditure. Now, the second factor is the way that the deficit of the national debt is impacting the country. So we call it national debt because the government needs to borrow money to pay for some of the things due to the lack of revenue. The third is the effect of the deficit, you know, maybe having a havoc thing, you know, it may be having a havoc on the country's economic affairs. So if the effect is mild, then the deficit isn't a problem, and it's the vice versa the case. Now, how to reduce the government budget deficit? See, there are only two ways to reduce the budget deficit. Okay, one is by increasing the revenues, and two is to reduce the spending. It's quite simple. Now, however, the government over here, it's quite tricky one. The two significant way to increase the revenue for the government is to increase the tax percentages. You can do that and to ensure economic growth. So if the government increases the tax too much, it would affect the economic growth, and an economy cannot be improved drastically. Now, to reduce the expenses, the government needs to reduce the expenditures. Reducing too much expenses will affect the economy of the country. Now, since the government spending is part of the country's GDP, too much reduction will, you know, slow down the economic growth. So the idea is to understand the current state of affairs and to decide what action can be taken in regards to the government deficit. I hope you have got a great idea regarding, you know, whether it is bad or, you know, every time it's not bad. Sometimes there are some reasons behind it. Now, what exactly are causing this budget deficit, which we learned, like slow economic growth, high government spendings, high unemployment rate, and the combo of the above. We also tried and understood the example. So I think this is a rock solid concept clearance topic, and majority all the things have been covered up.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.